Welcome back, sports fans. And today, I'm alone. Rack, sit.
Sorry, Cardi. I just got off my shift at the North Pole. That's why I'm late.
Get Jack. Because he's small.
All right. Let's just head to the intro. Other than my work up at the North Pole, I've been pretty busy down here with a great media team. The WACS Sports social media is back up and running, so make sure you go follow us on Instagram for all sports news and updates on this sports show.
Yes, it's very, very, very cool what Chenzo's been working on the past couple weeks, and he's got a good team behind him, like you said. But anyway, I think we should get into a little bit of up-to-date. First things first, on Monday, the boys varsity basketball team had a very, very tough loss against Holland. I mean, they played very, very good, and they lost. It was scored 54-57. It came down to a buzzer beater.
Yep. It was just 3 points. You know, we're almost there. I like what I see from this team, and, you know, it was a tough loss, but I'm confident that the boys are going to be able to bounce back, and they're going to be able to win here.
It's a good team. Along with that, the boys swimming team beat Iroquois with a score of 118-52. Not really sure how swimming works, but great job, boys.
Let me tell you, this swim team, they're looking pretty good right now. This is their second win of the season. They beat St. Joe's earlier in the year, 92-71. And let me tell you, there are some studs in this team. Like, I hear Liam Farrell, he's a pretty good swimmer out there, and I'm excited to see what this team does.
And finally, the girls varsity basketball team took a tough loss to Newfane with a score of 59-30. But speaking of girls varsity basketball, one of them won Athlete of the Week.
Oh, that's right. Let's send it to Athlete of the Week right now.
Jillian Yurich is a sophomore in her second year as a starting point guard for Bulldogs varsity girls basketball team. Her impact on the game can be felt on both ends of the floor. Defensively, Jillian is first in steals and third in rebounds this year thus far. Offensively, she leads the team in scoring and three-pointers made. Jillian was selected as an in-tournament all-star in the team's opening tip-off tournament at Maryvale High School, where she scored a tournament-high 21 points in the final game. Congrats, Jillian.
She motivates us in practice and games, and she's a good leader, and she doesn't ever give up. Leads the team in points, and she gives her all week in, week out.
Because I work hard in practices and in the games, and I am a leader on my team. It means a lot. I get to be a role model for my teammates, and it just gives me motivation going on in the season. My teammates and my coaches.
Now, let's head on to some Leave It to the Pros.
Carter, listen to this bold take right now. Buffalo Bills will win the AFC East, and here's why. Miami Dolphins lose to the Titans.
Mm-hmm.
That is huge for the Bills. Listen to their remaining schedule. Jets, mm-hmm. Not an easy win.
Ravens,
Cowboys.
Boys.
And then us.
I know.
To finish off the year.
It's got to be the hardest.
If they lose three games and we win out, we win the East, and we go from 6-6 to winning our division.
That happens, I'll be very, very happy, man. I mean, watching Josh Allen play against the Chiefs is just a great game. He's looking better and better every week. And I think something special is happening with this team, folks. I really do.
I know. It's fun to watch him right now, but at the same time, I've never been more nervous and more scared for a game in my life. This game against the Cowboys Carter, let's talk about how it is. It's a must win.
It's a must win. If we win this game, greatest Bills game in history of Bills games.
It's got to be. That's not even a bold take. I wouldn't even say.
I mean, you've got the best team in the league arguably coming in to our home, and we got to defend it.
Exactly. And I think we will. I think the boys pull out a win here.
Well, folks, sadly, it's all the time we have for this week.
Yep. I got another shift up in the North Pole tonight, so I got to get back up there and make some more toys.
But tune in next week, because it'll be a nice, chill Christmas episode.
And Rack will be back.